الحمد لله، الحمد لله خالق الوجود من العدم، وجاعل النور من الظلم، ومخرج الصبر من الألم، فملك التوبة على الندم. فنشكره على المصائب كما نشكره على النعم، ونصلي على رسوله الأكرم ذي الشرف الأشم والنور الأتم والكتاب المحكم وكمال النبيين والخاتم، سيد ولد آدم الذي بشر به عيسى بن مريم، ودعا لبعثته إبراهيم عليه السلام حين كان يرفع قواعد بيت الله المحرم، فصلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى أتباعه خير الأمم الذين بارك الله بهم كافة الناس العرب منهم والعجم. فالحمد لله الذي نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فقد قال جل وعلا في كتابه العزيز وفرقانه الحميد، بعد أن أقول أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق، خلق الإنسان من علق، اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم، علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري، واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علما. If you look at the first two revelations within the Quran, the concept is very similar. Where Allah Azza wa Jal commands Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by saying, اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق, recite in the name of your Rabb, of your Lord, the one who has created you. And then he says, what has he created you from? خَلَقَ الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ عَلَقٍ, he has created you from a clot of blood. اِقْرَأْ وَرَبُّكَ الْأَكْرَمُ, recite in the name of the one who is most kareem. الَّذِي عَلَّمَ بِالْقَلَمُ, who has taught through the pen. عَلَّمَ الْإِنسَانَ مَا لَمْ يَعْلَمُ, he has taught insan that which they did not know. And that's the one concept within these five verses where Allah Azza wa Jal is commanding Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that acquire knowledge, possess knowledge, and learn this beautiful deen. And when you look at the second revelation, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَا أَيُّهَا الْمُدَّثِّرُ قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ, has to do with this one concept of action, action, action. That have the knowledge of Allah, have the knowledge of this religion, and implement it within your life. If you look at the theme within the Quran, where there's so many countless verses, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, those who have brought iman, they should do أَعْمَالِ صَالِحَةِ, righteous, pious deeds. It shows that there's a condition that is attached with a person's faith. It's not sufficient for a person to say, okay, I believe in Allah, I believe in His Messenger, and he doesn't pray, he doesn't give any sadaqah, he doesn't fulfill the rites of Islam. It is a condition that is attached with a person's faith that he does a'mal salihah, he does righteous deeds. But the question remains, what comes first? Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala, in his book, in his Sahih al-Bukhari, he brings the chapter باب العلم قبل القول والعمل, the chapter which has to do with knowledge. Before blurting out something, before uttering something, before saying something, have the knowledge regarding the topic which you are speaking about. If you look at the Quran and that conversation that the angels had with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, before Allah created mankind, the malaika, the angels had reservation. قَالُوا أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءِ, are you going to create another creation that is going to cause havoc and mayhem and anarchy on this earth? And what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala respond back by saying? قَالَ إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ, I have knowledge regarding which you do not have regard. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, not by creating him bigger than the malaika, not by giving him wings, because technically speaking, the malaika do have more physical power than us, they are bigger than us in creation, but he elevated Adam alayhi salatu wa salam through knowledge. وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا ثُمَّ عَرَضَهُمْ عَلَى الْمَلَائِكَةَ فَقَالَ أَنْبِئُونِي بِأَسْمَاءِ هَؤُلَاءِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ قَالُوا سُبْحَانَكَ لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِلَّا مَا عَلَّمْتَنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. Adam alayhi salatu wa salam was elevated above the malaika because of his ilm and his ma'rifah and his understanding of Allah. When you look at all the galaxy of the anbiya, the previous anbiya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. وَتِلْكَ حُجَّتُنَا آتَيْنَاهَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ. That look how Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam intellectually defeated his nation. فَفَحَّمْنَاهَا سُلَيْمَانَ. Look at how we have given Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam that understanding, that ilm, that وَكُلًّا آتَيْنَا حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا. And you have given him hikmah and wisdom. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Dawood alayhi salatu wa salam and Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا دَاوُودَ وَسُلَيْمَانَ عِلْمًا. We gave David and Solomon ilm, knowledge. When he speaks about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَأَنزَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَعَلَّمَكَ مَا لَمْ تَكُنْ تَعْلَمْ. That O Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have granted you knowledge and wisdom, and ultimately this has elevated you amongst your people. وَكَانَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ عَظِيمًا. And Allah's bounty is numerous upon you, O the Messenger alayhi salatu wa sallam. And this is why Islamic knowledge is the highest level of knowledge. يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ. Those who have acquired this knowledge, Allah has elevated their status in this world as well as in the hereafter. When Allah Azza wa Jal intends good for someone, what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant that person? You know, often we would think that, oh, you know, Allah showed some mercy to some person because he became very successful through wealth. You know, he was a very successful individual. But what does Allah truly grant a person when he wants khayr? And in Arabic language, khayr is ismu tafdeel, right? It's the superlative noun that Allah wants the best for this person and Allah granted this person something. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. When Allah Azza wa Jal intends good for someone, He gives them faqaha, true understanding of this religion. And the same word, this beautiful word, faqaha, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua for his cousin, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhumah, Allahumma faqqihu fi ddeen. Oh Allah, give him faqaha, understanding of this deen. Subhanallah, Allah accepted this dua in such a way that Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma was given the title of Ra'isul Mufassirin. He was given the title of the chief of those who had understanding of Quranic exegesis. And later on, after the demise of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, at the Khilafah, when Umar radiallahu anhu was the leader, he used to have this teenager young boy who was at the age of 16 or 15 at that time sit in his consultation in his mashwara. And people used to have reservation. وَقَدْ عُوتِبَ مَرَّةً فِي تَقْدِيمِهِ لَهُ. Why is this young boy sitting over here? Some of them had kids, they had even grandchildren that were older than Ibn Abbas. So they were saying, why is this bacha sitting over here? Just let him go. You know, go let him play with the other kids. Why is he sitting over here with us? And remember, all these were prominent Sahaba radiallahu anhum who had gray hair, who had wisdom. And they saw Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were in the company of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, to prove a point, he asked a question. He said, do any one of you amongst us know the reason why the surah إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ was revealed? And none of them know the sabab nuzul, the reason why the surah was revealed. And he looked towards Ibn Abbas and he said, oh Ibn Abbas, do you know the reason why the surah was revealed? And he gave the reason why this surah was revealed, what was the condition of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what was the hala and what condition he was in, and why this surah was revealed. And he responded back by saying, إِنَّهُ فَتَلْكُهُولُ لَهُ لِسَانٌ صَغُولٌ وَقَلْبٌ عَقُولٌ. Listen, the reality is, he's a young boy, he may be a teenager, but the ilm and the knowledge that he has acquired from being in the company of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given this status that every time I consult, I have this young boy Ibn Abbas sitting right next to me. This is Umar radiallahu anhu saying this. So it is ilm, it is true knowledge, and this knowledge of deen that will elevate us as an ummah. And as Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned, that true knowledge is that which penetrates to the heart. علم النافع. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make dua for علم النافع. Allahumma inna nas'aluka علما نافعا. That knowledge which penetrates to the heart and transform a person. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma used to say, العلم يؤتى ولا يأتي. That knowledge, you have to go to it. It doesn't come to you. If anything comes to you, that's information. And we don't have the time to differentiate between information and knowledge. But knowledge is something which you have to sacrifice yourself and read and study and stay under the company of great scholars to acquire knowledge. You know, when you look at some of the great scholars of our pious predecessors, Imam al-Tirmidhi, Imam al-Bukhari, Imam Abu Dawood, and these accepted books of ahadith, Allah accepted these people because of their devotion and their dedication to His deen. And you see that some of these scholars would travel thousands of miles from one city to another city just to, you know, pass or understand a fatwa, just to understand what this hadith means. That was their shauq and their desire to understand this beautiful sacred knowledge that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has left behind. Because if we want to acquire from the inheritance of our Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, it is learning and understanding this beautiful deen. لَمْ يُوَرِّثُوا دِينَارًا وَلَا دِرْهَمًا. Because none of the prophets left any dinar or dirham behind. And even if they left any money behind, it was given to the poor and the masakeen. So what did they leave behind for their people? They left deen behind for their people. They left knowledge for them, for their people. For them to acquire that knowledge and understand that knowledge and propagate that knowledge. So it is very important for each and every single one of us to have this shauq and this desire and this understanding to acquire knowledge. You know, Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala, he, in one of his beautiful quotations, because he was such a great scholar and used to love poetry, he said, سَهْرِي لِتَنْقِيحِ الْعُلُومِ أَلَذُّ مِنْ وَصْلِ غَانِيَةً. And Ghaniya in the Arabic language is a beautiful lady by her nature, by her beauty. You know, not through makeup and, you know, beautifying herself, but just by looking at her appearance, you get fascinated by that beauty. He said, it gives me a spiritual ecstasy to be up in the nocturnal hour studying Quran and Sunnah and a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, than to be in the most exotic location with the most beautifulest girl and being embraced by that girl. This is how our scholars used to appreciate this beautiful deen. And you and I are living lives that we have deprived ourselves from acquiring this beautiful deen and to implement this beautiful deen within our lives. And this is why we have so much opportunities, you know, events after events where there's lectures, each and every single one of us to try our best to attend these events. And not only that, on our personal lives, we should be reading, you know, reading books, reading Islamic books, reading the tafsir of the Quran, reading the explanation of the Quran, acquainting ourselves. You know, even if you go on YouTube, there's so much content that you and I can listen to and try to acquire these knowledge that these scholars are propagating. I leave you with this last quote of Rasulullah sallallahu of one of the poets, that he said something beautiful. He said, Al-ilmu bahrun la sahila lahu. Ilm is the ocean which has no coast. May Allah Azza wa Jal give us the ability to swim in the ocean of knowledge and to derive from the wisdom of knowledge. Wa salli Allahumma barika ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. ألا إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات وبارك على محمد وأزواجه وذريته قال النبي صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر وأصدقهم حياء عثمان وأقضاهم علي وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة رضي الله تعالى عنها وعنهم اللهم انصر المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم انصر المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا لا تجعلنا فتنة للقوم الظالمين ونجنا برحمتك من القوم الكافرين اللهم إنا نسألك حبك وحب من يحبك والعمل الذي يبلغنا حبك اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا وشفاء من كل داء اللهم ارحمنا بالقرآن العظيم، اللهم ارحمنا بالقرآن العظيم، واجعله لنا إماما ونورا وهدى ورحمة يا رب العالمين. اللهم ذكرنا منه ما نسينا، وعلمنا منه ما جهلنا، وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وآناء النهار يا رب العالمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. أقم الصلاة.